to talk. I gotta tell what I feel. I gotta talk about my life as I see it.
Biggie.
Buenas tardes, damas y caballeros, bienvenido a bordo número 824 de JetBlaze con destino a John F. Kennedy, Nueva York. Mi nombre es Jasmine, para mí es un placer trabajar con Ryan y con César. El tiempo estimado sería de 3 horas y 30 minutos. Apagaremos nuestro sistema de entretenimiento mientras compartimos con ustedes información importante de seguridad. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome aboard JetBlaze Flight 824 with service to John F. Kennedy, New York. My name is Josh. Pleasure to be working with Caesar and with Ryan. Estimated time will be 3 hours and 30 minutes. We'll be turning off our in-flight entertainment system for a few moments while we share with you some important safety information. Por favor, dedique un momento para asegurarse de haber llenado todos sus documentos de llegada y tenerlos a mano para que los visite.
Ladies and gentlemen, JetBlue Airways welcomes you to John F. Kennedy International Airport, New York City. The local time is 6:35. Please keep your seatbelt fastened and carry an item stowed until the seatbelt sign is turned off. Be careful when opening overhead bins, as items tend to move during flight. If this is your final destination on JetBlue, your checked baggage may be claimed at the JetBlue carousel.
I got to talk. I gotta tell what I feel. I gotta talk about my life.
I've been waiting for you, man. You're like 3 hours late. What's up? What's up, man?
I got to talk. I gotta tell what I feel. I gotta talk about my life as I see it.
What's up, Bully Dan? It's your boy, Willie G here. We have a special guest. We're doing things a little different here in the Bully Dan today. I chose not to do it in the studio, because I wanted to get a real life feel. Because this is a very, 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 I don't think this has ever been done before. We have a special guest today. It's gonna be raw and uncut. gonna be all the questions that everybody be thinking, everybody be talking behind the scenes, but no one has asked them yet. Today we have Willie G. Willie G from the building today, and we're gonna interview him and see where his mind is at. Welcome to the show, my brother. Welcome to the show. Pleasure to have you. What's up, my brother? What's up? What's up? Thank you for coming through. First question. This is for a lot of people, I guess. Introduce yourself, first of all. What's up, Willie Dunn? It's your boy, Willie G. I'm here. My boy, Willie Guerrero, brought me here to this interview live. Okay, okay. How long you been in a bully game? How long you been messing around with the doors, period? Then, I've been in the bully world short time. I'm fairly new to the bully world, probably 4 years. However, my father always, we always had pit bulls. Since I was small, I always had pit bulls. My boy Angel and I, my boy Abby, we always had pit bulls. We used to walk around up and down the Ave, New York Ave, with our dogs. I've done breedings with American pit bulls, terriers before. I always had one since I can remember, and I'm an old dude. So I've been around the bully breed a very long time, over 25 years. With the American bullies, I've been involved with the American bullies like four and a half years. It's a little different. I remember with American pit bulls, we just let them breathe. Now, you have to do AIs, some people choose surgical AIs. It's different. It seems like these dogs are more, they look bullier, but I think they're more fragile than American pit bulls. Okay, so you've been in the game for a little while, huh? In some form or another. Very good, very good. Now, let's get right down to it, my brother. I've been waiting for you for 3 hours. You're 3 hours late. What was the holdup? It's kind of disrespectful. I'm late because, I'm late. I just literally came back from the Dominican Republic. I came from the airport here. Came from the Dominican Republic. I had to go take care of some business with my boy Henry Powell from the Dominican Republic. Him and I putting together a show down there in July. So we had to go work out the logistics and stuff. So my bad, my plane was delayed in Santo Domingo. But shout out to my boy Henry and his wife Liliana. They cook us some good food when we go down there. But that's why I'm late, man, my bad. But I was coming here regardless. You know that, I told you that. And that's what it is. Okay, so you was in the Dominican Republic hanging out with Henry, huh? Okay, good deal. We hope to have Henry in this show in the Bully Den in the near future. I think we're gonna go down on July 11th, July 24th, I believe, down to the Dominican Republic for a show, and we will try to get a footage of the whole bully movement down there in Dominican Republic. So that's awesome. Okay. Now, you are. What's your role with CBR, the Continental Bully Registry? My role with the Continental Bully Community, I did not start it. Megan Porter started the Continental Bully Community, CBR. When I decided to leave RKC, I was just, my mindset was like, I'm just going to hit every registry and I'm just going to have fun. I'm not going to get caught up in one registry no more. At that time in CBR, there was a friend of mine, Jamie McClendon, and he hit me up, man, and Eric Baton, they hit me up. Yo, it's funny, yo, this is an exclusive. I'm going to tell you how I got involved with CBR. Jamie McClendon hits me up. He's like, him and I used to always talk, and he hit me up. It's like, Will, man, I see what happened. Boom, boom, I heard. Yo, why don't you come over? We got this new registry. I'm part of it. Why don't you come on over, man? And I was like, I got to think about it, man. At that time, I wasn't sure I wanted to get involved with no registry again. You know what I'm saying? So I told him, so let me think about it, man. I got to talk to my wife. You know, I'm in this position right now where I'm all confused and, you know, I'm caught up in my feelings. I don't know. So then, boom, the next day, I never heard of Eric Maton in my life. He inboxed me, started asking me questions and stuff about my RKC and stuff. And I'm like, yo. But a lot of people were doing that at the time. You know, a lot of people want to know what's up. So, you know, boom, boom. I told him, scientists ain't happy. You know, I kept it very vague, man, because my business is my business. And this is the first time publicly I'm speaking about the whole situation. So, I told him, I said, yo, I'm just not happy. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, I'm just going to chill and do me, whatever. So, yo, but then, you know, I didn't know at the time. I found out way later that, you know, Jamie and Megan and them and himself, he was involved with CBR. They were, like, seeing where I was at, you know what I'm saying? So they were, like, kind of, you know, just sent a scout out, a recon mission. And luckily, you know, I don't tell my business to anybody, man. So, you know, boom. So they just wanted to see where I was at. And then after that, you know, I was like, well, why not? You know what I'm saying? It's a new registry. You only had, like, 80-something people. So I was like, let me get involved in that and see, you know, where would this go? And here I go. I'm not the owner of CBR, though. There's several boss owners. I am part owner. It's Judy, Mike, and myself. We are the owners of CBR. I, however, have, you know, taken a little step back from it because I have too much going on right now, you know, with my move and all that. I'm like, I don't have time for the daily operations of that, man. It's a lot of work to run the registry. And like I heard on last week's episode of ES Live, it's a lot to run a registry. We have invested a lot of money. A lot of money. Myself and the cooks have dumped a lot of money into CBR. We haven't made one penny. But I do it because I love it. And, you know, it's a passion. It's a hobby. Expensive hobby, but it's a hobby because I'm not making money. Judy's the president, so Judy runs it. You know what I'm saying? I normally go along with it. You know what I'm saying? Unless if it's something that I feel real against, then, you know, I would speak up. Then I will put my two cents in there. Other than that, I just want to, you know, stick to the visual. I want to really focus more on the Bully Den show, you know what I'm saying, on Willie G Films. And so that's basically what it is. You know, I'm a firm believer in the chain of command. I'm a firm believer there's a role and everybody has a position and everybody should play that position, you know what I'm saying, and I'm a firm believer in that. Even though I'm part owner, I don't think I should be trying to step over Judy's toes or Mike's toes. Like, for real, like, I hardly speak to the judges. And if I do, anybody will tell you. Any judge will tell you in CBR. I never ask them their picks. I never ask them why they made choice. I never question their choices. I don't. That's not my position. I play my position well. So right now, I think while I step back, I think James Turner and James Scott are holding the media position, and they're doing a fine job. I see James Turner putting up videos, man, and taking awesome pictures. So, you know, it's not a one-man show, and then that's what it is. And, you know, but that's what it is with CBR, man. It's crazy. I never thought that it was going to grow to this stage where it's at now. I didn't think it was going to get this big. You know, and we're going through a phase right now. We're going through a changes, and I'm sure we're gonna go through many more changes because it's a learning process. None of us knew about these dog registry things. You know, I've reached out to certain individuals, and they have given me tips and stuff. And that's what it is, man. I do a lot of fun shows out here in the tri-state area. You know, I have fun, man. I'm just about these bullies, man. I support all registries. I'm going up. There's a new registry out here in the tri-state. It's called ESK. No, I'm sorry, ESKC. ESKC, and it's by my homie, William. And, you know, I judged his fun show before in the past. My boy Will from Connecticut, I judge his fun shows. My boy John Truitt from Cali, I judge his fun shows. Dominican Republic, I judge fun shows. I enjoy that, though. To me, that's giving back. You know, and I have fun, man. And anything that I support, anything that's positive with the bullies. I don't care what registry it is. If it's positive, I'm down with it 100%. By the way, I want to give a shout out to my boy. My boy hooked me up born to breed bullies, man, American bullies. Shout out for the hat, I got it, man, and I'm rocking it, you know. So he sponsored the Boom Den Show. Shout out to him, man, and that's what it is. Let's build up the segue there. What happened? This is the million-dollar question that I'm not afraid to ask you. What happened with you and the RKC? Okay, with the RKC, man, that's my home at the end of the day, man. I'm gonna keep it real. You know, that's where I started. I had great times there, man. It was an awesome time while I was there. I had lots of fun. I've learned a lot of things. Met good people. I'm still good friends with a lot of people from the RKC community. I don't want to beat around the bush. You asked the question, what happened with me and RKC. To put it short, man, you know, a lot of changes was happening over there. You know, it was growing at a rapid pace, man, and I was going 1,000% with it, man. And I just, the boss over there, man, started putting people in key positions, and I felt cheated. I felt that I did so much for it, and I got passed over, and that's the God's honest truth. Now, I didn't just leave pissed off or none of that. I mean, you know, I don't go around talking bad about RKC or no one there, man. I just felt some type of way. And I always say, and anybody who knows Willie G, who knows me well, we always tell you that my philosophy is, if you're not having fun or you're feeling some type of way about something, then there's no need to start chaos or being bitter. You know, you just pick up and move on if that's what you choose to do. I'm the type of person where I don't like to hold grudges. I don't like to be at a place where I'm feeling some type of way, so I'd rather just keep it moving. But there's no love lost. Last year I went to RKC show. This year I was supposed to go out to VA to Emporia. Shout out to my boy Izzy Natal. I was supposed to go to his show. On the way there, you know, I stopped at a dealership and I picked up a car. So, you know, it didn't make sense for me to drive two cars on there. So I turned around and came back home from PA. You know, there's no love lost at all. I'm planning to hit up the RKC show in New Jersey. That's what it is. I was not trying to take nobody's situation. I wasn't trying to take nobody's spot. I think that at that time, most of the people that got put in certain positions, they deserved it and they earned it. The majority of them. I wasn't trying to steal the media spot from Spielberg or none of that. I think it should have been two spots. You know what I'm saying? I think it should have been visuals and audio. But, you know, and that's what it was. And when I left, I didn't just leave bitter. I called up the bosses. You know, I called Fabian up. I spoke with Irv. I spoke with Chris Hodge. You know, I spoke with the OGs over there at the time. And, you know, I told them, you know, how I felt and what was going on. Actually, me and Fabian had booze on the phone for like 2 hours. You know what I'm saying? So it wasn't like I just left and started talking crap. I don't get down like that. That's what it is in a nutshell. But there's no love lost. I still got love for the RKG. I got love for all registries. I said, yeah, because you was promoting that hard. You was going hard for the RKC. And I'm glad to hear that that's still all love. Okay. Now, you're involved in the bully community. What is where you want, where you see Presidente Bully Kettle, Willie G, heading to in the near future? Okay, the future of Presidente Bully Kettle. I did downsize. I downsized because, because of the reason that I told you earlier. I'm moving to North Carolina. So, you know, I didn't want to bring on a bunch of dogs to a new location where I have to you know, rebuild and get and settle in before I could do that. You know, I think before I was all over the place, so I had a lot of dogs, and now I know what my program is, what I want my program to be, what my vision is. I know the type of dogs that I love now, and that's what it is. And I kept four. Actually, I got five. One is in North Carolina. Shout out to my boy Kent. He's holding one down for me down there. But all five of them have the characteristics that I love. I mean, everybody has their own type of dogs, and I don't knock no one's dog or style. Mine, I like them short with big blocky heads, you know, and I love short dogs, thick short dogs with thick heads. That's what I look for. So now I kept the face of my kennel, Riddick the Bull. I have York. Boy, he's not even one yet. He's gonna turn one in May 1st. Phenomenal. Phenomenal. He's a power trained. Let me go back to your Riddick. Riddick is off of Prince Roy's and Runway Bullies, Whitey McTighty. Of course, that's Bullseye and Dax. Short, stocky, girthy, big head. That's my style of dog. He's the face of my kennel. Then I have York. York, shout out to Kara and Donald Green. I got him. He's off of Power Train and Peaches. Power Train is off of G-Train. Peaches is 100% Gotti Girl. So, you know, he was short. Man, I fell in love with him the first time I saw his picture. I was like, I gotta have that dog. I reached out, got him up here. Actually, they brought him up to me all the way to New York, Donald did. And so he's, man, that boy's not even one yet. He'll be one May 1st. And he's short, thick, big head. And he's correctly, he's sound. You know, he's structurally sound. Boy's correct. That's where I'm gonna start off my in the ring. So then I also have, I acquired some pups. So I got a female, a chocolate female, her name is Yahoo. I got her from my boy KB Kenneth out in Texas. I reached out to him. He has a cheese off of a Romeo, rated R superstar. He's a son of a Bullseye. And she was bred to his chocolate girl. So I was like, he had a couple of litters. I'm like, yo, I'm gonna holler at you when I'm ready. He had a litter drop. He reached out to me. He's like, Will, I got this one coming. I'm like, yo, I want in on that one. And we made that happen. So I kept her. She's short. She started to blow out. And that's my style of bully. So that's my female. I have two females and two males. My second female I have from my boy Quincy Fields. He had a badass litter, an all-tri beautiful litter. You know, him and I were chopping it up. I was like, yo, you need to send one of those up to New York. He's from New York originally. So he was like, yo, I'm coming up to New York in a couple of weeks. I'm going to holler at you. He came through with his family. I met the family. We met up in the BX in the Bronx. I got that little girl for him. And I love how she's turning out. I mean, she's still a baby. But so far, I'm loving what I'm seeing. So that's what I have. And then of course I got my kennel partner Debo from Blue Chip Bullies. My Dominican brother from up here, upstate New York. He did a breeding in Dominican Republic, and you know, that's my homeland. So I went down there, and he made it happen. You know, he went down there and brought up a couple of dogs. I couldn't keep all those dogs, like I said, because I was downsizing. So him and I spoke. I sent the female iHeart down to Chicago. My boy came up with his family. My boy Pro Dog, Avis Pro Dog 24. He came up. Shout out my brother. He came up, drove up from Chicago, came picked her up. So he has it over there on Cone with us. And then you know, I have the litter mate to that dog, which is Cheese's. They're off of Capo. Capo is he's off of Miyagi, and Capo was bred to a Dax daughter. So you know, those pups, the one that Kent has in North Carolina for me, the foreign boy, he's Miyagi and Dax. So And he's turning out bad too. He's only a pup, but I'm loving what I'm seeing. Big heads, short. That's just my style of dog. And that's why I cut down, you know, but I think I have a nice foundation to keep getting what and improve on what I want to get. Because, you know, Reddy got some things that you know, I got to fix his rear. So, you know, hopefully I have a stock now that, you know, the offsprings will come out nice. Okay, well, you heard it from the man, Willie G, from the mountains, from the horse's mouth, I should say. Now that we're moving around the things, we also aware that you are moving to North Carolina in the near future, right? Or is that a rumor? Good. You know, I've been in New York. I was born and raised in New York. I've been here, you know, all my life, with the exception when I was in the Marines, and, you know, I lived in North Carolina, in Jacksonville, in Camp Lejeune, you know, in Japan and stuff. But the exception of that, you know, I've been here all my life. And, you know, New York's too fast-paced, man. It's too expensive. We pay $15,000 at the house in taxes. So, you know, I'm like, you know, the weather sucks now over here in New York. Maybe it always has. I just was used to it. But, you know, I just want my daughters to grow up in a slower pace. And, you know, I think Chickie's good. My wife has family down there. And Durham Rally area, so, you know, I got a lot of heads out there. You know, I have a lot of good friends down there. So it was only logic. You know, originally we were thinking about Florida, and I even looked into Texas. But in Texas, I don't know, you know, I don't have family in Texas, and that's far from all my family from New York and Florida. So then we were going to go to Florida. That's where my wife is from originally. Well, she's from Brazil, but, you know, when she came here, she, you know, she lived in Florida. So she was gonna go to Florida. I got a lot of family in Florida. So, you know, Florida, man, is a great place to visit. It's too hot. You know, I still like to see the seasons change. So the next logical spot was North Carolina. I mean, I couldn't go too deep down country in there neither. So, you know, we settled in on Durham. I already have a job lined up there. God willing, everything goes through. Job possibilities, I should say. Lolita has a job lined up already over there. So it's official, man. In June, we're going down south. But moving along those lines, man, I'm glad you took the time out. I'm glad you came and hung out with us a little bit. Well, we learned a couple of things from Willie G that we didn't know about. So that's a plus. We're getting the exclusive live and uncut, only here. That could happen in the Bully Den. We're almost wrapping up. He has to go back. I gotta start editing. So tell us, what happened with you and your good friend, F.W. Spielberg? Okay, wow. As far as the Spielberg situation, man, I have nothing but love for Spielberg, honestly. Him and I, man. When I was going through the whole deal with my daughter, man, he held me down. He used to be in my house every day. Him and I used to eat, drink, and make our videos and radio shows. And he was definitely a crutch when I was going through my deal with my daughter, the latter part of it. Excuse me. So, you know, I have nothing but love for Spielberg, man. I was not trying to, like I said earlier, I was not trying to take his position. I think the man is a genius. He's great at what he does. I mean, I don't think, I'm honestly speaking right now, I don't think there's not an entertainer or an MC out there that could do it better than him with that mic. I actually tuned into his radio show last week, and I had a great time, man. Like, you know, we're not best of buds no more because circumstances, you know, with the whole RKC thing, you know, he's, you know, that's his place. And, you know, we just... You know, that got in the way of our friendship, I guess. You know, and among other things, people telling me stuff, and I'm sure people telling him stuff. But the reality of it is, I didn't want his position. I'm not the audio guy. Actually, I stepped away from the RKC 101. Yeah, I enjoyed that show. That was a good show. That was very good. That's a great way to start off in the bully community. It's just, you know, that audio thing is just, you know, it's not 100% me. And, you know, but he's good at that, man. And I don't take that away from And I want to make it very clear, I did not leave RKC because I wanted Spielberg's position. I have nothing but love for Spielberg, man. We just went different ways, I guess, or we let people, you know, and these dogs get in between our friendship. And it's a shame because a lot of people lose friendships, man. They lose good friendships and good people in their lives because of these dogs and because of the people in the bully world. I'll be honest with you, man. I was in the music industry, man, for many years, and that place is grimy and shady. But I think the bully community, the bully world, has a beat. Man, people will make things up about you. People assassinate your character, but it's part of the game. I mean, you have to have a thick skin. You know, I tend not to. My New Year resolution was not to get caught up in the bully garbage. You know, I tend now to keep to myself. I have very select few people that I speak with in the bully community. And I think that works out the best. If I hear some nonsense about Willie G, I brush it off my shoulder and I keep it moving. I don't even entertain garbage or gossip no more. Honestly, don't. But I have nothing but love for that man. We'll talk. Okay, that's interesting. That I'm sure that was a question that a lot of people wanted to know, and no one really brought it out to light like that. Thank you, brother, for getting intimate and personal with us, sharing your experiences in the bully game. Okay, my brother, thank you for coming through. Any last words, as I normally ask every guest of the Bully Den? Leave us with your last words, any shout-outs? All right, I just want to give a shout-out, man. I definitely want to give a shout-out to my extended bully family, man, Down Country Kennels. James Turner, Alicia Turner, Oscar, Easter Bullies, those are my extended family, man. Who else, many of them, that I look up to a lot in the bully community, Antonio McClenny, of course the Cooks, anytime I have a question, whatever, man, I gotta talk about it, give me the right way, it's a lot of people, man, that I'd rather stop right there because I don't want to leave no one out. My boy Ken, holding me down, man, good dude, Izzy. Damn, man, I'm gonna leave so many people out that help me out. Mike and Nicole Barker. I better stop, man. The entire Eastern Bullies, y'all know who y'all are. Of course, I gotta give a shout out to my little princess, Ariel. Stepping away for the first time last month, man. Proud. My wife, Lisa, holds me down with these dogs, man. I don't know what I would do, be without her with this dog. I definitely wouldn't be able to have all these dogs. And nothing, man. I just want to give the entire bully community a shout out. Let's keep trying to do right by the street. Let's keep moving forward. And everything else, man, I can't preach to y'all. Everybody's a grown ass person and they're going to do what they're going to do. I love everybody, man. Willie G loves everybody. I don't want no problems. That's my new resume. I don't want no problems. I love everybody. You don't involve my family, man, and everything else is just child's play. So I just want to give a shout out, man. I love everybody. The boy Willie G signing off from the Bully Den. Thank you for having me here, man.
I got to talk. I got to tell what I feel. I got to talk about my life as I see it.
Well, there you have it from the man himself, Willie G. He was a special guest in this episode of the Bully Den. We have first time ever Willie Guerrero interviews Willie G. So there you have it. This is a monumental thing. I think a lot of things have cleared up. And on that note, let's go to our sponsors. Shout out goes out to everyone who participate and watch and give me their time to showcase their kennels or the insight or the experiences in the bully game. Another one is a wrap. Your boy Willie Guerrero signing off from the Bully Den Live.